Next year's midterm polls will afford offshore-based Filipinos to vote online. But a party-less representative cast doubt on the software and systems provider for next year's polls over the vendor's rather dubious or seemingly spotty resume. Yet the poll body pushed back and expressed full confidence on the ability of their chosen vendor to deliver. As the poll body's 2025 budget took front and center in today's House hearing, as well as the CHRs that PTV's Noel Talakay reports.
Madam Chair, I move to terminate the proceedings for the Commission on Human Rights and the Human Rights Victims Memorial Commission.
Madam Chair.
Seconded, Madam Chair.
Yes, there's a motion to terminate the budget hearing of the Commission on Human Rights and its attached agency, and the motion are seconded, so the motion is carried.
This is the signal. The House Committee on Appropriations approve the proposed 2025 budget of the Commission of Human Rights, or CHR, after deliberations today. During the hearing, one of the issues tackled was anti-enforced or involuntary disappearance act of 2012, because the CHR did not allocate any budget for it. According to Gabriela Partilist representative Arlene Rosas, there should have been 10 billion pesos earmarked for its implementation.
So Madam Chair, kung wala tayong nilalagay dito, oo, paano to implement, Madam Chair? So, tas may mga cases ka ng ganito, 14 under this administration, Madam Chair.
The CHR was also asked on how the agency ensures all Filipinos are protected from any human rights violations. Such inquiry made in light of Batangas Representative Mark Goh's assertion the Philippines ranked 100 out of 142 countries in the World Justice Project Rule and Law Index. Not only that, the agency is also getting the least appropriations in the bureaucracy or among all government agencies every year.
Bagamat ho kulang ang resources ng komisyon, ay ginagawa ho namin yung lahat ng aming makakaya upang tugunan. Kung titignan niyo po yung aming mandato, napakalawak po niya.
Meanwhile, the Commission on Election, or COMELEC, also faced the members of the House Committee on Appropriations to defend its budget for 2025. The chairman of the agency is looking forward for a greater allocation next year, since they will be conducting three elections in 2025, the midterm barangay and Bangsamoro elections. This poll trifecta has been dubbed super elections.
Magsasuffer po ng konti sapagkat yung nawala po na 14 billion sa amin. Although naunawaan po namin ang liit na physical space na meron ngayon ng pamahalaan, matutuwa po kami kung mababalik po sana. Subalit ayaw na po namin ibigay pa yung pressure sa kagalang-galang na Committee on Appropriation tungkol sa bagay na yan. At naniniwala naman po kami na kung ano man po yung binawas ng Executive Department ay may kadahilanan.
The COMELEC will be piloting online voting for Filipinos based overseas in the 2025 elections. Chairman Garcia aced the doubts of the lawmakers on the credibility of the machines and integrity of the systems to be used for the vote transmission, plus the connectivity status of the different countries.
Lahat ito po ay gumana na ipakita po na pwede pala yung mga system na to ay mag-handshake at mag-coordinate, and therefore can perform simultaneously during the conduct of the election. Doon po sa mga malalayong lugar, nag-test na po kami. Halimbawa sa Simunul, Tawi-Tawi, ay gumamit po yung provider ng Starlink, and lahat po ng mga equipments nila as of kahapon ay na-deliver na po sa amin. And that is now the subject of the hardware acceptance test by September 11. Titingnan po namin kung talagang gumagana lahat, maayos ba yung mga equipments, and kasama na rin po yung mga makina.
The Commission on Human Rights, or CHR, is proposing more than 1.1 billion pesos for its next year's budget, while the Commission on Election is requesting over 34.4 billion pesos budget in 2025. These two agencies are hoping their budget will be given green light at the plenary. the funds will be used to finance programs and projects for the benefit of the public. Noel Talakay from the National TV Network for New and Better Philippines.